Hello, Hall. Hope you're doing well. We're back with another New World video, and today we're going to be talking about luck and yield. Two very, very difficult topics to understand in New World, but I'm going to do my best to try and keep this as simple and as focused as possible. You're going to want to make sure you understand this, because if you're at all interested in crafting in New World or gathering items and putting them up on the auction house, things like that, this will allow you to get more bang for your buck. All right, let's jump right over here and talk about it. Now, yield is the concept of the amount of common drops you get when gathering, mining, skinning, and logging. So you can influence your yield various ways. We're going to talk about that in just a sec. So whenever you farm, like, say, an herb, just that purple plant that you see everywhere in Aeternum, you get a common drop, which is hyssop. Same if you see an orichalcum node. Orichalcum is, you get orichalcum ore, that's the common drop. And if you see hemp, you get fibers. Well, if you also have luck paired with this, you have the chance to get an additional drop, things like garlic if you're farming herbs, or if you're farming orichalcum, you can get void ore, or if you're farming hemp, you can get that additional higher end fiber. So just keep in mind, yield is the number, the volume of common drops you get. Luck influences the chance at a secondary drop happening, whether it be uncommon or rare. All right, let's continue on here. Now, the next slide I have for you shows you how you increase your yield. And the most important question you're going to have is, why do I want to increase my yield? Well, if you get your yield over 100% additional, you have the chance to earn double uncommon and rare drops. So that means when you're out there farming your orichalcum, a super hot resource in Aeternum, you have the chance to get void ore, not once, but if your luck and yield are high enough, you have a chance to get two pieces of void ore instead of one. So that is why we want to get our yield up over 100%. So how do we do that? There's lots of ways, two of which are very difficult to get additional bonuses, and everything else is sort of in your control. So your faction controlling the Windsward Fort. What do I mean by that? So here I am, and we're looking at Windsward. Now, Windsward controlled by the Marauders, that's not my faction. I am part of the Covenant. So we're not talking about Windsward, the town or the territory. We're talking about the fort. If I click this fort and you look down here, you see gathering quantity plus 10%. That means globally, the Marauders get a plus 10% gathering bonus. So this one's very difficult, right? Because you're going to go out there on a PvP mission. You're going to flip that fort, and that fort could be flipped back by the time you actually get out to your gathering location. So this one's sort of out of your control, and I think very difficult. The next way you can influence your yield is if your faction controls a territory in which you are farming in. Again, that's out of your control. You may be one person, you may be a solo player, and you just happen to be part of the faction that doesn't own the territory that you want to farm in. So that's sort of out of your control. That's another difficult one, but it's very easy to understand. If we just jump back over to the map here, as I mentioned earlier, I'm Covenant. So if I farm herbs in First Light, which I often do right through this area right here, I've actually made a video on that run. You can come here and you'll get a plus 10% bonus if you're the matching faction that owns this territory. So that is a plus 10% yield bonus for me when I'm farming herbs in First Light. The next item is owning a house. Number three here, owning a house where farmers harvest, and we're using farmers harvest, we're using harvesting and gathering as an example here. If you own a house where the lifestyle buff is active, now that's pretty easy to control. You can control where you buy your house. That gives you a whopping 20%. So where do I find that? This is a tough one. This one's sort of buried in the menu system. So let me show you. You actually want to go to your character tab and go to bio. And then you want to look at the various towns. And you can actually go to the town desk and look at the lifestyle buffs. But I have a house at Everfall. And if I click Everfall right here, you can see they have a, looks like a cooking buff happening, an armor inspiration buff happening, an engineering's presence buff happening. So they don't have a gathering lifestyle harvest buff happening. So I'm not gonna get the 20% because I do own a house in Everfall, but they don't currently have that buff active. So that's super important because you're gonna need that 20% to get up over 100%.
The next one is pretty straightforward. Number four here, you're going to want a sickle. We're using harvesting for our example here with the yield perk. So let's jump back over to the gameplay here, and you can take a look at my sickle. And if we look, we pull up, it's an Orichalcum harvesting sickle. It has a harvesting horticulture experience on it. That's a not really a great thing when you have level 60 already, but you want harvesting yield. That's plus 18% to your yield. And then this one has Azoth extraction, which is very good. But normally, instead of experience, you would want harvesting yield and harvesting luck on your sickle. But this one has yield, which is very good. So plus 18% there. And if we continue on here, you can also consume a powerful potency booster. So what is that? If we go check out the auction house and jump in here, let's just go on the auction house and let's just search for proficiency. And you see common proficiency booster, powerful, strong, weak. Let's go look at the top tier one. It's about 100 gold. This one, if you read the description here, increases the amount of resources gathered by a tool for 15% for 30 minutes. So this is another 15%. This is super easy. Anyone can buy this. These actually aren't crafted in Arcana. They're crafted by on the workshop. So interesting little twist there, but just be mindful. Usually pretty abundant on the auction house and a great way to get more yield when you're out there doing your farming. All right, let's go up. Number six here is having 250 in your stats for whatever you're doing. So in this case, we're talking about harvesting in our example, and that is an intelligence-based quality. So let's jump over here and show you exactly what I'm talking about. If we go in and we look at our character sheet again, and we're looking at attributes here, you see my intelligence is spec'd for 256. And you see at these individual increments, you get a little bit of a bonus for whatever one you hit. Well, if you hit the second to last one on the intelligence side, you get a 10% yield when harvesting. So that is an additional 10% yield right there. And then it sort of works across the board. So this one's for skinning if you're in dex. This one's for mining if you're in strength. I think this one's fishing and this one is logging. So that's pretty well thought out. I actually think that's pretty cool the way they did that. So let me move back over and let's talk about the last thing here. And that is the gathering card territory bonus. So what do I mean by that? Gathering cards, as you guys know, and you're sort of working through your territories. If we go to the map here, you can look at your territory standings. And when you gain influence in a territory, you get to pick one of these things. You guys have seen that card come up many times if you've been playing New World. Things like trading tax, property tax, gather, station fee, storage, and XP gain. I think housing here as well. You're going to want to pick gather every time. Do not fall into the trap of picking XP gain, because once you hit level 60, that is just sort of wasted. And I wish I could go back and redo it and do gather pretty much every time it comes up. A good healthy gather number is about 27, 28, 29, 30% gather. If you're getting that, that is a huge number to your yield. All right. And with all that, if you're able to achieve these things right here on this list, you can get up to 113%. I use an 18% harvesting yield on my sickle as the example, because that is the percentage I have on mine. That adds up to 113%, and you can remove probably one of these 10 percenters and still get it. And that's probably going to be controlling the Windsward Fort. So just remember, you're over 100%. Just keep an eye on those uncommon and rare drops, and you should see, if you're over 100% added yield, you should see you should just see an additional one every time. All right. Now, what else can influence the amount of rare drops we get? Well, that is luck. We talked about luck a little bit. Luck is pretty straightforward. There's a few things you can do with luck. You could eat food. So if you look here, we have cooked corn. Increases luck when harvesting by 1,000 points for 20 minutes. So that gets your luck up significantly. You could add trophies to your home. So this week I just added a major gathering trophy, which is sort of like an in-game gathering trophy, but there's minor and basic as well. So whatever you're working on, you buy a house, you either buy the trophy off the auction house, or you pay somebody to create it for you. And there you go. You put that in your house and you get those bonuses when you're out there gathering. And obviously we talked about in this example here, I've got a very nice sickle here. That sickle has yield and luck on it. So you could get luck on your gathering tool as well. And then additionally, you can get armor in the game that increases your luck. So on the right top right there, I have the hat, the shirt, the gloves, the pants, and the boots for increasing not only your intelligence, but also increasing your luck. It says rare items, but that's actually I think that's been reworded. This is an old picture. That actually has been reworded to increasing your gathering luck. So there you go, guys. I hope this was helpful in understanding how that all works together. I tried to keep it as short as possible. We're at about 10 minutes, and I won't keep you any longer. Guys, I stream New World five nights a week over on Twitch with some other games as well. And I just want to say thank you for watching that video. If you enjoyed it, if you found the content helpful, please, please leave a subscribe and a like and maybe a comment down below. And guys, we will see you all in the next video.